English grammar will teach you today a very easy topic of your English grammar. Before we start the real content, let me show you some sentences and let's discuss that first. First of all, we know that punctuations and these kind of things matters a lot in our life. Let's see sentences. Let's eat grandpa. Let's eat grandpa. So have you observed any kind of things which matters a lot? Yes, obviously. Whenever we are speaking this first sentence, let's eat grandpa. And secondly, let's eat grandpa. So it means in one sentence, it is looking like that here is a dish. In the dish, we have to put grandpa and we have to eat grandpa. And in another sentence, it is looking like that we are calling to grandpa that yes, grandpa, let's eat together. So this is the differentiations we can see in the first sentence. Now in second statement, first of all, let's read it out. Private, no visitors allowed. Whenever we are having some private gardens, whenever we are having some private institutes, so we are able to see these kind of sentences in front of the gate. Second, private, no visitors allowed. So have you observed anything in these sentences? So answer is yes, we have observed. Here we can say full stop. So I have just spoken as it is a full stop, right? Private, no visitors allowed. It means this institute, this garden is private. No any other people are allowed to go in that. The sentence shows to us. Now the second one of this, private, it means someone is asking that is this private? No, this is not private. Visitors allowed, it means this is not private garden, this is not private institute, and we are allowing people to come inside of it. So understood, right? Because of one full stop, one question mark, one exclamation mark, and because of that, the whole meaning of a sentence is changed. Now the last, as we know that whenever money matters in our life, so it makes a huge difference. And whenever it is a matter coming to us, that whenever we want to give money to another person and whenever we want to take the money to another person, right, or from the another person, it matters a lot. For an example, if I want to give a check of 1 lakh rupee to someone, or I want to get the check from one person of 1 lakh or 1,000, whatever it is, right? So in that, money matters a lot. So let me give you an example of this. And here the example is, you can see 1000, then I have kept here full stop, then 2 zeros. Now first of all, in our mind, questions arises like this, then what is the matter if we are putting comma, if we are putting full stop, what is this, right? But it matters a lot. Let me tell you that here it is 1000, 000. So few things are coming in your mind. Yes, you are right. Whenever I will speak these, so these rupees are 1000 rupees only, getting it? Why? Because I have kept here full stop. See, this is full stop. So whatever the content we will write after full stop, that will be not considered in money. Now in this, whenever we are writing, 10,000, right? So after 10 we are putting comma. For an example, another example is there, that for an example it is 10, right? So here it is 10,000, but just a moment, if I will rub this comma, if I write full stop here, then it will be converted into rupees 10 only. So this is very important for us that where we are putting comma and where we are putting full stop. So whenever we want to give a check to someone else of only 1000 rupees, right? So make sure that you are putting comma or full stop, because it matters a lot. Otherwise, you want to give check of 1000 rupees, then you will give the check of 1 lakh rupees. It can also be happened. By the observation of such a sentences, I think you begin to know that which easiest chapter, easiest topic we are going to have in this video. Right? So yes, give me answer. The answer, whatever is coming in your mind, that is the perfect answer. And today we are going to learn about the punctuation. Right? So punctuation is very important whenever we are writing some contents. So in board examinations, we are having 4 questions of punctuation. It contains 2 marks. So mark weightage is 2 and we have to attend 4 questions. So let's learn today punctuations. So finally, as we have discussed in introduction, that today we are going to have the topic punctuation. So many a times whenever we are just observing these kind of topics, so we are finding that it is very and very easy. But what is the matter of that? That already we have discussed in the introduction. Now let's have some purpose of introduction and of punctuations. So first of all, punctuation introduces appropriate pause in a sentence. So this is very important for us, and already we have seen in the introduction, right? In that 3 examples we have seen. So punctuation gives a particular pause in a statement or in a sentence. So we are having a lot of punctuation marks in our syllabus, and which kind of punctuation marks are in our syllabus, that we are going to see. Before we go, again let me remind you that punctuation marks are coming in our board examination with the marks weightage of 2 marks and 4 questions you will have. So that's why it is very important, because these kind of marks are called as an instant marks. It means if your answer is right, you'll get the marks. If your answer is get, so by means we have to take care of both the things. Then as it is an instant marks given, but then we are just losing our instant mark too. It means that if our answer is not right, then definitely we will lose our mark. But we have to be very positive in this, because these are our easiest topics. So we will learn this and we will take instant marks in our board examination. So first of all, in our 10th standard, in syllabus, the punctuation marks are full stop, comma, semicolon, colon, quotation mark. In quotation mark, we will have both the quotation marks. It means single inverted commas we are telling and double inverted commas we are telling. So that also we will see to it in that sub points. Next thing is question mark, then exclamation mark, brackets, apostrophe, hyphen and ellipsis. So from these, few are looking very common. It means I think we are just learning them from 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th standard, and we are very familiar with these topics. But few are looking like that we have to learn them now in a new way. So finally, as we have discussed, punctuation marks are very important, and punctuation marks gives a particular pause to statement or sentence. Let's have the another example of importance of punctuation. First example, woman without her man is nothing. Let me speak the another example. Woman without her man is nothing. Have anything strike out in your mind? Have you observed anything? So obviously I have written the conclusion of the same sentence, so obviously you will get this. First of all, woman without her man is nothing. So in this sentence we can say that importance of a man has been shown. How? Let me explain. Woman without her man is nothing. It means woman need her man, right? That's why only after that only a woman can be the perfect. So here they have been given to us that woman without her man is nothing. If there is a no man in life, right, in wife's, in woman's life, then there is an importance of man has been given. Now let me show you the second sentence. It means that woman, now here the colon has been given. See, and we all are knowing that what is the meaning of colon. Colon means whenever we are just observing any dialogues of a drama, or in chapters also we are having so many kind of a chapter in a dialogue form, in a drama form. So we are observing such a thing that woman say, caller it means generally we are speaking, understanding the same, that woman says, without her, man is nothing. So importance of a woman has been said. True. So here very easy to understand that here we have used comma, here comma, and here full stop. Here colon, here comma, here full stop. So getting it? Half comma, the getting changed place. According to that, the meaning also gets changed. So we have to be very careful that what we want to show in the sentence. If we want to show the importance of man, then we have to put comma after man. If we are taking comma just before man, you can see here we have said, see the differentiations, right? So just where we are placing comma, so it get changed this exit meaning. So this is very important for us to understand that now I can say that these all the punctuation marks are having their own importance, how we are using it. One by one we will see all together. First of all, our first and very common punctuation mark is full stop. Let's have that full stop. First thing of a full stop is to mark the end of a sentence that is complete sentence or statement, we can say. So we know that we all are having our stories. We all are having our textbooks, right? So in the textbook, whenever the statement completes its meaning, after that we are putting full stop. We can say such a thing that whenever we want to give a huge pause in a sentence, it means that whenever we want to complete the sentence, at that time we are using full stop. The another example I can give you, that I have eaten mangoes. After that I must use full stop. Why? Because I have completed the statement. Whatever I want to convey the meaning, that already I have completed. So rest of thing I don't want to add. Yes, now in 10th standard we are having the kinds of a sentences also. In that we know that we are having simple sentences, so very easy to identify the simple sentences. After that we are having complex sentences and compound sentences. So in that we will have the different kinds of phrases and clauses. So at that time we don't have to get confused, because whenever we are having compound sentences and complex sentences, so in there will be two clauses. One can be a main clause, second can be the substitute clause. So that kind of thing, in those sentences where to use full stop and where to use comma, that we have to learn very carefully. Just of all, now to mark an end of a statement, whenever we feel that here the meaning of its, right sense of its completes, at that place we have to put comma. Now let's go for the second one, in some abbreviations. Now you will feel such a thing that what is meaning of abbreviation? Let me give you one example for just if I want to write December, but there is no space, so I will write in a very easy manner that DEC, December, will pose it. Second example, if I want to write USA, the full form is United States of America. If I don't want to write the full stop, I will write only USA. Getting it? Another example, I want to write doctor, but we are not writing hall doctor, right? We are writing DR. So we are having a lot of examples of such thing that we have to use comma as an abbreviation, right? Second thing, if I want to write that Mr. and Mrs. So in that also I'm using, or we are using Mr. MR dot. So we can find in our routine life lots of and lots of examples of such that commonly we are using, but we are not aware of that we are using full stop in this sense. So this is very important for us. Now whenever we will complete all the chapter of punctuation marks, after that whenever you will use in a routine life, in a common life, you are writing your answer sheet even, at that time also you will be very much aware of this, that oh, here I have to put full stop, here I have to put quotation mark, here I have to put comma. This is very important for us, because these are very important, because we have seen this in the video, that it gives complete meaning of a sentence. And if we are not using a particular comma and full stop at a right place, so meaning of a sentence is getting changed. So if you want to avoid some misunderstanding, then we must say that we have to use commas, or we have to use full stops, or we have to use all the punctuation marks in their right way. Now in abbreviation we are having the sub 2 points, and those sub 2 points are there. You will have a question that ma'am, if in end of a statement, in end of a sentence, if we have used abbreviation, then are we supposed to add the another full stop to complete the sentence or not? Second question you will have in your mind, that ma'am, for an example, if there is an end of a sentence and that statement is question mark, right, with a question mark, there is an interrogative statement, so are we supposed to put full stop after that or what? So let me clarify your this very important query. So for an example, if my sentence is that am I going to for an example, we can say that am I going to settle in USA? So we know that the sentence ends with a question mark. And am I going to settle in USA? So last statement we have seen wordings are USA. It is a question mark, right? We know that. So this is very important that we have to put this. It means that if it is interrogative statement, we have to put this in as an abbreviation. But if it will be a very simple statement, declarative statement, so that statement is the same question, we can give answer that yes, I am going to settle in USA. That is a simple statement, that is a declarative statement. So in that, after USA, that again full stop we don't have to put. Getting it? So if it is an interrogative statement and if question mark will be there at end of a statement, so this is we have to write. We don't have to miss it. Otherwise many a times the question arises that there are two types of punctuation mark we have to use altogether. But yes, here we have to. Right? So USA, so here this is not used as a full stop. This we have used as an abbreviation. Right? So USA, then full stop as use of a USA in a short form, and after that in addition. Now here the question mark, right? This question mark is for interrogative sentences. So those particular question marks, exclamation mark that we will write. So here today we have seen the importance of punctuation mark in your syllabus, which kind of punctuation marks are going to come. After that we have seen the purpose of punctuation, right? It means that whenever we want to give a particular pose, whenever like we want to show something, we want to focus on something, so those particular things, for that we have to use punctuations. Secondly, we have seen the very important example, right? As you know, we have already discussed. And again, revising the same, that first use of a full stop, that to mark the end of a statement, right, whenever we feel that the sense of a sentence or the completion of a statement has been done. So after that, we are putting comma. After that, in some abbreviation, we have seen so many examples, and one task is there for you also. that now onwards, whenever you are speaking such a statement, whenever you are reading in the newspapers, whenever you are writing anything in your classwork, in your homework, whatever you are writing, whatever the subject is there, you have to focus on punctuation marks, right? After this video, whenever you will read something, you will write something, you will definitely have the strikeout in your mind. And here is a punctuation mark, here is a comma, here is a quotation mark. Now, for quotation mark, I must say that in the previous standard only, we have understand the topic. In this standard also, it is going to come direct and indirect speech. So in that, we have used excessive use of a quotation mark. So those particular examples in a deep, we will see whenever we will have that topic. For now, we have completed the topic of punctuation mark, full stop. Rest of things we will see in the next lecture. Thank you.